Hey everyone, my name is Wolver Leader. I'm a software engineer and cloud architect. And in this video, we're going to learn how we can generate code using GitHub Copilot and GitHub Copilot Chat in Visual Studio Code. Now, GitHub Copilot can help us develop code more efficiently and accurately. It generates autocompletion suggestions as we type our code in the editor. And it can also generate suggestions based on code comments that we put in our code editor that contains natural language text. The GitHub Copilot Chat extension in Visual Studio Code also generates code suggestions for us based on our chat interactions with GitHub Copilot and our code base. There's also supporting smart actions that enable us to complete certain tasks without having to write prompts. So to get started with Visual Studio, GitHub Copilot in Visual Studio Code, we're gonna need two extensions, and I've installed them already. But if I go into extensions here and type GitHub Copilot, it's the second one there. But essentially there are two extensions that we're gonna need. We're gonna need the GitHub Copilot extensions, and we're also gonna need GitHub Copilot Chat. Once you've installed these extensions and provided that you've got a GitHub Copilot license, whether that's an individual one or provisioned through your organization, that's called GitHub Copilot for Business, you'll be able to, once you authenticate with your GitHub account, you'll be able to use these two extensions. Cool, so if I go back into my Explorer, I've got a C# file called book.cs. And in this, what I want to do is generate a class that represents a book using codeline completions. Now, first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to show you a couple of ways how this works, so a couple of things that I've experienced. The thing with generative AI, it really does depend on the context. So when you're testing this on your machine, you might get a different output. But let's start with a comment. So I'm going to write public class book. And I'm going to say include the following fields. I might spell include correctly. So I'm going to say ID, name, author, price, and quantity. So it's kind of guess what I'm trying to say here. Now, if I press enter, let GitHub Copilot do its thing, it's going to suggest another comment like that. So yeah, that's a public field, but it's not exactly what I want. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that. Now, instead of a single line comment, what I found with C# and Visual Studio Code is if I do a multi-line comment like that, even though it's only on one line, then press enter, then I start to see some C# code. Now to accept this, we can just tab our way through it. But if we highlight that as well, we usually see a couple of suggestions. So here it's suggesting that I use a using statement for the link library, but also for the text library as well. And we can accept that with tab, or we can cycle through those suggestions that GitHub Copilot provides to choose the suggestion that we like to have instead, if there's an alternative one that's better. I'm going to go ahead and delete all of that though. Because what I find is a better way of actually getting numerous suggestions from GitHub Copilot in Visual Studio Code is by pressing Control Enter. And what that's going to do, it's going to suggest 10 code suggestions. Well, so I was provided 5 that time. Usually I get 10, but sometimes it's, you know, less than that. In this case, it's 5. And this will contain a few suggestions of what we want to achieve, using our comment as the context. So it's here, I've got a book class inside a namespace, bookstore. Got another book class here with some using statements, one with a default constructor and another constructor here. If I scroll to the top, this is what I want. So just a basic class for my book with the quantity, with the field, sorry. So the ID, name, author, price, and quantity. So to accept that, I'm just going to click accept suggestion. I'm going to go ahead and save that file. Now, if I wasn't happy with those suggestions, all I need to do is just get out of that and then press Control Enter again, and that would generate some new suggestions for us, which is pretty cool. Cool. So now I've got my book class, we're going to implement a couple of methods in our program.cs file. So this is just a basic console application with a main method. But now what I want to do is generate a method that's going to generate some book data for me. So I'm going to write a comment. So what I'll write in this, so create a method called generate book data that returns a list of books with random field values, assigned to each field. There we go. I'm gonna press enter and then give Copilot a chance. And there it's actually suggested or generated a method for me. If I highlight over that, that's the only suggestion that I've got. You may get numerous suggestions, but again, to accept this, I'm just gonna press tab. So there I've got a method, generate book data, that's going to go ahead and return a list of books to me with randomly assigned fields, which is pretty good. So rather than having to do all that grunt work myself, it's provided a suggestion for me, which is pretty cool. Cool, so that's how we can generate code using inline comments. The second way we can do this is generate code using GitHub Copilot Chat. Now, the GitHub Copilot Chat helps us to create code using the chat interface and smart actions. We can use prompts to ask GitHub Copilot to create new methods for us, and Copilot will provide suggestions for one or more method signatures and implementations. And then we can review this and accept one to help us create an initial cut of our code more quickly and accurately. So if you think of a problem that you're trying to solve in your head and you're not quite sure how to implement it, you can use GitHub Copilot Chat to basically ask the question, how do I solve this problem? And it will suggest some code based on the problem or based on the prompt that you've given it. So, and this is particularly helpful when you want to develop code that implements resources that you're not familiar with. So if you're wanting to implement a new library or use a library, sorry, that you're not familiar with, if you're developing in a framework you haven't touched before, if you're developing with APIs, GitHub Copilot Chat is fantastic as an AI pair programmer to help you gain a better understanding of what you're trying to do. Now, in Visual Studio Code, the GitHub Copilot Chat extension includes three interfaces. So we've got the chat view, we've got quick chat window that can be used to ask a quick question and then we can get back to what we're doing. And then we also have inline chat as well. And this basically is an interface that opens directly in the editor, and this provides contextual interactions while we're coding. Providing GitHub Copilot with prompts or questions that include a clear scope and intent helps us improve the quality, or helps GitHub Copilot improve the quality of its generated responses. So we can ask questions, provide context, and outline requirements in a conversational style, and GitHub Copilot will then use that information to generate suggestions. Now, there are three things that we can do to improve our chat suggestions. First up, we can use chat participants. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to open a chat here. And one thing that we can do with chat participants, we can use workspace. So this will ask about our workspace. Say if we have a terminal open, it could ask how to do something in the terminal. And this essentially helps GitHub Copilot Chat understand the context of your question. There are also slash commands as well. So if I go slash explain, it's going to help us explain our code. Or if I'm going to want to create something new, I can create, say, like a new file or a new project within this workspace. And then finally, what we have are chat variables. So if I just use something like file, I can pick a file. And then from there, I can pick which file I want to use as the context. Or I could use something like editor as well. So this is visible source code in the active editor. And this helps GitHub Copilot focus on something specific when considering the larger context of your question. Cool. So what I'm going to do, here I am in my program.cs file. I'm going to create another method. So I'll create a new comment. I'm going to go create a method that displays a list of books to the console. Make this nice and simple. Now, what we can do is we can actually generate this method using inline chat. So what I'm going to do is position my cursor below, and I'm going to ignore that for now. I'm going to click press Control I. And what I can do is I can add a, provide a prompt, sorry. So create a static method that prints the details of a list of books to the console. And I'm going to go ahead and press enter. And it's going to help generate that code for me. So there we go. So there's my static method. And what I'm what it's done, it's actually used a list of books as a parameter. And then for each book, it's going to display the information about that book in that list to the console as well, which is pretty neat. So to accept this suggestion, I can click accept here or use Control Enter. We can discard it or we can rerun it again. Let's do that to rerun a new suggestion, but it's come up with the same thing again. So I can go ahead and just accept that. So there's my public method for displaying books to the console, which is pretty neat. Cool. So now what we can do, we've got our two methods here. So let's have a look at how this chat interface works and see if we can implement or get GitHub Copilot to show us how we can implement those two methods inside our main method. So I'll actually go ahead and go back into the Explorer because I want to show you how the shortcut works. So to open the chat view in Visual Studio Code, I'm going to go Control Alt I, and that's opened the chat interface for me. But you can also click on this chat icon in your activity bar. So whatever works for you. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask a prompt. So can you show me how to implement the generate book data and display, what's the name of our method? Display books methods in my main method. Now, this is going to work in this situation because my program.cs file is open, so it's going to use that as the context. So if I press send, so I'm going to, it's basically using that open file as a reference. While that's going ahead and actually generating a suggestion for me, one of the pieces of advice that I can give you for code completions, open the right file. So I opened up my program.cs file here, and what Copilot did, it looked at the current and open files in my editor, and it analyzed the content of that and used it as the context to create the right suggestion. So having the right file open while using Copilot will help set the context and lets Copilot see the bigger picture of your project. So make sure you have the right files open. Another way that you can actually do this, if I just go back and just copy and paste that, I can actually refine this even further. So I can say main method in my dash file, and then you select the program.cs file to use that as my context. So if I send that again, I've got my program.cs file open, but then it's also used the program.cs file that I've given as an explicit reference. And there it's going to generate the code for me. The idea is, as long as your prompt is clear and specific, Copilot will be able to provide a suggestion that's useful to you. And as always, you can iterate on this. You can reject the suggestion, refine your prompt even further to get a better response from GitHub Copilot. So that's given me basically a sample of how I could implement it. So it's given me, just open that a little bit more. So it showed me the my generate book data method that it generated earlier, also my display books, but it showed me how to actually call those two methods inside my main method. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy that. You have got a couple of options here. So you can actually copy all of this code to the clipboard if you click on copy there. And you could also apply into the editor directly as well. So you don't have to do what I'm doing. I'm just copying these two lines of code, because those are the two lines of code that I'm going to need. So I'm going to go ahead and click save. So let's give this a test. So I'm actually going to go ahead, open a terminal, control backward slash. You might call it something else. I call it a backward slash. It's not like a forward slash. Just have a look at my directory. So I'm just going to go the CS profiles there. So .NET run. And let's see if GitHub Copilot has actually generated code that compiles and runs. So it's certainly thinking about it. And there we go. So there are the books being printed to the console, which is pretty neat. So I can see that my list of books is being generated randomly. Obviously, you know, we're just populating our properties using random values. And then I've got my display books that's actually displaying all the information about the books in the list. And Copilot, my program has compiled and run, so that's worked perfectly for me. Fantastic. Another cool thing that we can actually do using Visual Studio Code is using voice commands to GitHub Copilot. So let me find the extension for you. So if I go into extensions here and look for VS Code Speech. There we go. So this extension brings speech to text capabilities to Visual Studio Code. And the way this works with Copilot, if I go back into my program.cs file, let's go ahead and just remove that for now. And I'm going to open an inline chat, so Control I. And I am going to just click on, Control I. Click on the voice and go, generate a method for me that displays the books to the console. Okay, so it kind of cut out for me. There was a bit of latency there with my voice, but there you go. It's produced the code for me. So if you'd rather not type it and you want to use your voice, or you need to use voice for accessibility reasons, you can use the VS Code speech extension to speak commands to GitHub Copilot, and it will generate code for you in the inline chat. And also, I'll accept that. So my code actually compiles, and Control Alt and I. We can also do that using the chat view as well, which is pretty cool. Awesome. So this was just a very quick video on how we can generate code using GitHub Copilot and GitHub Copilot Chat in Visual Studio Code. In our next video, we'll look at how we can actually generate unit tests with GitHub Copilot, and we'll learn how we can actually refine our prompts to generate output that's specific and relevant to us. We'll also show you how, if we keep our prompts very generic, we might not get the results that we expect. If you like this video, give it a like. If you have any questions, pop them in the comment section below. And if you want to see more videos like this and other videos on AI or Azure or any kind of programming videos that I want to do in the moment, don't forget to subscribe. No matter where you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day, and we'll see you all next time.